In this short video on SOLIDWORKS PDM Standard, we're going to look at workflow approval process. So we'll see how PDM enables us to control access to documents based on an electronic workflow. This enables us to streamline company procedures and processes. It gives access to the data when it's needed. It enables approval control. It gives us the ability to automatically capture key approval information to write to the drawing board, and also enables automatic PDF generation. So let's first of all see how we can use the electronic workflow to limit or grant access to files based on the electronic state the file is in. So if we log in as the viewer, browse into the project that we're looking at today, and we can see the folder is empty, so we don't have access rights to the data in this folder. If we now log in as an editor, browse into the same project, we can see that we have access to this data now, and we can see the state of the files are in work in progress. So I'm happy with this design. I want to get this design signed off, so I'm going to push the file through the electronic workflow by changing state of the file. So I'm going to submit this for checking. I'm going to add in some comments, which we can make mandatory. And then I can specify who I want to notify electronically, so when they log in to PDM, they will get the notification that the file has changed state. So I'm going to change state of all of these files in this assembly, select OK, and these files will then progress from work in progress to pending check. If I try and push the files further through the electronic workflow, I have no access right. I have no rights to do that, so I'm not able to self-approve and sign off my own work. So I'm now going to log in as the checker user to push these files through to the next stage in the electronic workflow. As soon as I log in, I get this notification balloon appear that I can click on, and it will tell me what has changed. So we can see that these files have changed state from work in progress CAD to pending check, and I can now select any of these links, or I can view the data card, look at the history. So I don't need to know where these files are within the PDM system. I can simply click on the folder link and it will automatically take me to that data, where I can then preview this and sign this data off once I'm happy with this then. If I'm happy with this, I can now go ahead and change state of this, and I get the ability to push this back to work in progress via the editing required transition, or we can say this is checked ready for approval. So let's go ahead and do this. So again, I'm going to add in a comment. And then again, I can select who I'm going to notify dynamically from a list of users. I'm going to transition all of the data set now and select OK. And once I do this, it's going to now change the state of the file to pending approval. But what it will also do is it will capture who's checked the file. So it's got my initial there, the date it was checked, and we still don't have the approval information because the file is pending approval. So finally now I'm going to log in as the approver now. And again we get the notification balloon appear. And if we click on this, we can see that the file is changed state from pending check-in to pending approval. Again, I can select one of the hyperlinks to take me to those files. And then I can review the design. Once I'm happy with this, I can then sign this off. So if I now go ahead and change state, again I can reject this to go back to the check-in stage, or I can approve this. Select OK on this, change state of all of the files so they all get released, and select OK. And these files will now change state from pending approval to approved. What it will also do is it captures all of this information on the data card. So it captures my initials, the date the file was approved, and also stamps in the history of the file, revision A. And a PDF will automatically be generated for this file automatically as well there. So as we can see now, the PDF has been generated. If we look at the preview of this, we can see that we have all of the information here. So all of the drawing board has updated with the metadata from the data card. So all of this information we can push onto the drawing board, which in turn updates the PDF file automatically. So we've not had to go and open this up manually and change the drawing board there.